Ladies and gentlemen, hey, hi, how you doing? Welcome back to the channel. If you remember back during Modern Warfare, prior to every single new season going live, we actually got a handful of new teasers ahead of time, like various map teases, operator teases. Eventually, we got some Warzone changes and teasers for those. And here in Cold War, it seems like that pattern is going to be repeating itself, as today, we actually got the very first Season 1 teasers for the upcoming update next week. And then on top of that, Treyarch also recently revealed some other new info regarding Season 1 as well. So as we go through everything today, if you enjoy the video at any point, let me know by dropping a like on it. And, of course, if you're new to the channel, or if you're watching and you're not already subbed, we are trying to hit that spicy 669k subs before the end of the year. So if you want to stay on top of basically everything going on in COD, this is the place to be, so feel free to subscribe and maybe even turn on those post notifications. Also, right now, code IMMORTAL is actually going to get you 30% off your G Fuel order, so if you want to grab anything in time for the holidays, right now is a great time to do so. And then if you want to enter the massive giveaway that myself and G Fuel are hosting, that'll be coming to a close here on the 12th, and the info on how to enter that is down below in the description. Anyways, getting into the brand new Season 1 teasers first and foremost, just like back in Modern Warfare, it appears we're going to have a handful of smaller teasers leading up to the full Season 1 reveal, which I would assume is probably going to take place sometime early next week if I were to guess, and Treyarch did mention that they would be previewing a bit of the Season 1 content throughout the upcoming days, and today those previews got officially underway with a special package that was sent out to a handful of creators, like my friends Espresso, Inkslasher, and Charlie Intel all got one. This package included a radio, some codes, a world map, and some notepaper, alongside the URL of 67376343674.1.com, which is by no means easy to remember, and this actually prompts you to enter a username, and as of right now, any username seems to work. And then when you input that username, a timer would actually appear counting down to this morning at 7 a.m. Pacific time or 10 a.m. Eastern. So, come 7 a.m. Pacific time, the site wanted us to enter Sequence 1, and alongside that, the first broadcast sequence went live, and the radios that all the creators got started broadcasting a signal of just how many times I've died to the doof doof in Warzone. Now, somehow, that sequence translates to the code of Payback, so when you go ahead and enter that in the Sequence 1 line, you then move on to Sequence 2, which actually had like a whole countdown timer. You couldn't go in and just enter these back to back to back. You basically had to wait for the countdown to expire, and then you could move on to the next sequence. By the way, the code is actually deciphered through the codes page that the creators got. You actually go in and subtract some stuff to figure out a number to letter cipher. But anyways, for Sequence 2, we got another series of numbers when Clark Griswold and his lady friend appeared on the COD broadcast. And same deal to decipher this one, and the code comes out to Stitch is coming. Now when you go ahead and enter this code, you get an absolute ton of information on Vicar Stitch Kuzmin, who appears to be the Season 1 operator. That's the name that we saw leaked a few days back, and there's a lot of info on Stitch's life. Somehow no mention of Lilo, which is somewhat unfortunate. But this Stitch is a part of the KGB, or was a part of the KGB, and reported directly to Krevchenko, familiar name there. Russell Adler apparently took his eye during an interrogation as well. There's also mention of the Gulag, so a bit of crossover there. And Project Nova is also mentioned, which actually has some references to it in Warzone, and presumably that's going to tie into the Rebirth Island map as well. Then for Sequence 3, same deal, new numbers, new code. This time around, the code is going to be Remote Control. This one simply unlocks a little RCXD minigame where you can jump from platform to platform, but honestly, this one is really nothing too crazy. Moving on to Sequence 4 now, more numbers yet again. And this time around, the code is going to be Interrogation, and when you input this into the site, you get a very, very pixelated image of Nuketown that you can then actually clear up by clicking on it, I think. Otherwise, I just timed it like really, really well when it was loading in, but yeah, just a bird's eye view of Nuketown. Really, I'm not too sure what's going on with this one. Now, for Sequence 5, surprise, surprise, we've got more numbers and another code. However, this time the numbers were actually given to us in Russian, so we got a bit of a curveball here. But if you ended up doing the Warzone Easter egg with the bunkers, you probably won't have too much of a rough time with this one, really. And this time, you want to enter the code Vodianoi. I'm probably mispronouncing that. And this time we get a map that shows a projectile of some sort flying over, and when it lands or strikes the target, we see a quick glimpse of it being referred to as Nova, and then the feed gets corrupted. So this appears to actually be some sort of Nova 6 bomb or something, hitting and then actually going off. Also, for what it's worth, that is pretty much where Rebirth Island is located according to the leaks, so I definitely think that is relating to that. Then we get the final sequence, number 6, and here we've got some more Russian numbers. This time the code is Vazrazhedenia. Definitely 100% mispronouncing that one. And entering this code actually brings you to the Season 1 cinematic for Cold War, which, well, it's pretty cool if you ask me. Here we get our very first look at Stitch, the operator himself. We get our first look at Rebirth Island. It is now 100% official. Rebirth Island is coming. It is pretty much just like Alcatraz from Blackout. It's got a few extra things by the looks of it there. But yeah, very, very cool stuff there. And basically, this entire trailer is from Stitch's point of view, going over his sort of backstory and his beef with Russell Adler. Obviously, as we talked about before, the two don't really get along well, to say the least. Stitch here is talking about how he was working on Nova 6 on Rebirth Island. Then eventually, the Americans found out. They came and sort of attacked the whole area. And that's where things really, I guess, started to go downhill. He also mentions Kravchenko again. So really, I guess this is just putting some visuals and also a voice to all the info that we got from the earlier sequences. But I think it is safe to say that it is very, very clear that Stitch is pretty much in an all-out war with Russell Adler because of the events that took place prior to Season 1's storyline picking up. And as this trailer goes on, we basically see a trap that Stitch is setting up for Russell Adler and his team to walk into. And as we get towards the end of this trailer, it pretty much concludes with Stitch saying that Russell Adler is his and the rest of his team is gonna die. Then we see the whole Season 1 free content update coming on December 16th. So obviously, quite a bit ends up stemming from this first initial teaser and reveal, I guess. This isn't everything, as we're gonna get to here in a bit. We've got even more info to go over as well, but from this, we get everything from the Maul DLC map preview to Rebirth Island to Stitch, all just from this one single cinematic. And honestly, I think it all looks very, very exciting. Now, Treyarch has also revealed a bit of info over on Twitter, actually. Tony Flame, who is one of the leads over on multiplayer, ended up tweeting out saying, "Cold War guns and attachments in Warzone? Oh yeah, the best of both worlds come together in Season 1 with cross-game progression to boot. Expect new weapons, score streaks, maps, aka raid and more, game modes, blueprints, operators, and more." Now, this tweet ends up sharing a pretty decent amount of info for just simply being a quote tweet, right? Obviously, we've talked about some of this leaked content already between some of the weapons, like the Mac 11 and then also the Groza, the modes of Dropkick, which apparently is going to have a callable nuke available in it, and so on and so forth. But what's actually really cool about these confirmations is that for the very first time ever in a Call of Duty game, it seems that we're going to be getting some Score Streak DLC, which, like I said, this would be a first for seasonal or post-launch content. Previously, the new content that we got throughout the years was always based on characters and weapons and maps and camos and whatnot. Score Streak DLC was always something that was talked about and asked for by the community, but it just never came to fruition. At least until now, it seems. And something that's kind of peculiar about this situation is that pre-launch, we actually had several Score Streaks leaked, including ones that we don't actually have in the game right now. So you may kind of see where I'm going with this. There were a handful of other streaks that sort of disappeared after one of the pre-launch updates. So maybe we're going to end up seeing those presumably cut streaks added into the game throughout these seasons during the year. We also had the leaked dogs streak from a few days back when we initially talked about some of the Season 1 leaks. The K9 unit was, of course, a beast of a streak back in like BO1 and BO2, so that could potentially be coming as one of those seasonal streaks. Then pre-launch, we also saw things like the Death Machine, kind of a classic one there. The Flamethrower was also in there, as was the Hand Cannon, which I believe we even saw in the campaign. Then we also had the Strafe Run, aka the Bombing Run. And finally, the one I hope to see the most, the VSAT, or the HARP as it was also known, which is basically just like an advanced UAV, and it highlights everyone and their precise locations on the minimap. So we could actually end up seeing some really cool additions with the Season 1 update, and of course the future updates as well, with a brand new content addition alongside the usual weapons and maps and all that good stuff. But yeah, there you have it. With all of that being said, that is effectively everything that Treyarch has revealed about the Season 1 update so far in terms of teasers and whatnot. And that is going to wrap things up for today. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know by dropping a like on it. And, of course, if you're new here and you want to stay up to date with the latest Call of Duty news, intel, updates, and pretty much everything else in between, feel free to subscribe with your notifications turned on. That way you'll always know whenever I upload a new video. Also, right now, Code Immortal is going to get you 30% off on G Fuel, so if you want to grab anything there, be it a new tub, a starter pack, a shaker cup, anything like that, Code Immortal has got you covered just in time for the holidays. And if you want to enter the massive giveaway that myself and G Fuel are hosting, that comes to a close here on the 12th. So if you're interested, check out that link down below for info on how to enter. But once again, thanks so much for tuning in. And until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.